Hoi. Hier is nog zat plek, dus kom vooral lekker binnen. Voordat ik mijn verhaal ga starten, zijn er twee mensen die hebben gevraagd of ze wat mogen zeggen. Dus allereerst mag Dennis van Zuylenkom naar voren komen. Oké, dan gaan we beginnen met TD Venlo. Die hebben gevraagd of ze wat mogen zeggen of kunnen zeggen. Of... Het is mij onduidelijk, maar ik moest tijd inruimen. Dus dan doen we eerst TD Venlo, dan gaan we daarna gewoon terug. Hallo, Erik.
Ja, die microfoon was al. Aan deze speciale hackerspace eigenlijk, het hotel, ontbrak nog één ding. En voordat jij gaat openen, hebben we een kleinigheidje voor je.
Wauw.
Alsjeblieft, je space state.
Wauw, that's awesome. Kijk, en nou snap ik ook...
Dit is de URL. We gaan hem ophangen.
En nou snap ik ook waarom zij als eerste moesten en echt niet ik kon beginnen. Dus ja, ik denk dat ik hem open ga zetten. Als ik het nou niet overleef, mijn speech staat hier. Dus, Oké.
Hij staat ook op hackerspaces.nl.
Okay.
Op het kaartje. Wow. Dus hebben we samen met Dave...
So thank you so much to my friends from TD Venlo, and now the official opening then. Thank you so much.
Yeah,
thank you, very cool. Okay, we're open now. I'll put it here because I really like it. Jelle, thank you so much. Thank you, TD Venlo. Very awesome. Yes? Yeah, cool. Okay, if Dennis has arrived, then please, Dennis van Zuylenkom, can he come forward? Dennis, you can walk straight on the stage. Please. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Dennis van Zuylenkom.
Hallo. Nederlands?
English, please.
English. Okay. Welcome to Hacker Hotel. My name is Dennis van Zuylenkom. I will be doing my portrait photography project, Shoot All the Hackers, in the Albert Einstein room. That's, up there. I invite you all to join me, and I will take a beautiful photograph of you. Just find me wherever. I won't be there all day, so just look me up and ask me.
Okay, so if you want a very cool picture, look up Dennis and he will help you out. Thank you so much, Dennis. So then now, can I start? Some of you recognize the layout. It was done by my great friend Michael again from England. He did it so well last year. It helps me so much. So I just pass all the stuff to him at 6 a.m. this morning. And and he makes it. So again, welcome. Thank you so much that you all are here. This is the agenda, my welcome, some house rules. I put them in the beginning again, like last year, because it needs to be set, but then we can go on with the fun stuff. Something about organizing Hacker Hotel for the fifth time. Feedback and improvements. Meals. Some questions to you. Some sponsoring, some badge stuff. The big thank yous, of course. The badge, the coin, and the design competition. And something to never forget. So, first, the house rules then. No smoking inside. And this also includes the bungalows. So you can smoke, you can even smoke weed in the Netherlands for the foreign people. There's no problem, but please smoke outside. Last year, a lot of people put stickers on the whole hotel. Everything was stickered. Also, the electric charging pole outside where you can connect your electric car. So we have a lot of stickers present here, and we love them. Put them on everything you own, but not on stuff of the hotel, which you don't own, please. Saves me a lot of headaches and saves the hotel a lot of cleanup. But we do love your stickers, and if you have awesome ones, especially with exploding stuff or lasers or whatever, bring them to me, please. So please, don't bring your drinks in, like rum, and ask the bartender to pour you a Coke, but wait, and then you pour first your whiskey and then have him pour the Coke or something. That's not really recommended. And also, I would like you to ask you to refrain from bringing your own drinks into the communal areas. And that's very important. The communal areas over here, where is it? There. Because we have a whiskey tasting. And I arranged with the hotel that we can have a whiskey tasting. It will be up in the boardroom tomorrow night, starting around 12-ish. If you brought your own bottle, you can bring it, but you can only drink it in that area. And I'll come back to that later. Also, if your zero emission hybrid car, yes, we're changing and we're going along. If it's full, please empty the space so another person can charge his car. Some people cannot get home if you don't leave your, you take your car away. So please be excellent to each other. So remove your car if it's full, and if you need to charge, charge it, please. And the last rule, of course, don't be on fire. That's rule zero in every hackerspace. We don't have a workshop, but with all the equipment we have, it's easy to understand that we can be on fire, so please don't be on fire. Organizing the fifth hacker hotel. Of course, it started after the last one, and it started basically during the last one. As you can see, last year we were in the other room. That was like this size, 200 persons, 50-day guests. We're now at 330 capacity and 45-day guests tomorrow. So it's growing. Thank you for that. We sold all the hotel rooms. I will show you a graph, nice graph later. We sold all the hotel rooms very quickly, I might add. So then we started selling the bungalows, and we sold those quickly as well. We have more excellent, helping, awesome sponsors, which make this possible. Because we grow, the chairs you're sitting on had to be rented, because we are so large now that the hotel didn't have enough chairs. All the chairs could be in this room, and then we didn't have anything for the other room. So we rented chairs. That's extra cost. We had to buy you breakfast. That's extra cost. So without these sponsors, this won't be possible. So I will come back to them later. But think of this, as you grow, you have extra costs, which I not always accounted for. So that's great that there's people supporting you and helping you with that. And we have more goodies and swag. More on that later too. In the end, organizing such a big event, you get lots of questions. People assume things, that they can bring animals, that they can bring 10 friends at the last day, that they can bring their own drinks, like all kinds of questions, and that sometimes gave some frustration, which was, people could see that in my tweets. So that's some point for me to improve on, but we'll have some improvements. But first, the graphs. This is where we started selling the tickets when we opened the ticket shop, just during after Hacker Hotel, so it shut up. This is 110 sales per month, so this gives you an idea of the chart. Then it dropped down to 50 a month, 30, and at this point we were sold out. So this is July. So in July we were already sold out for an event starting this February. This small climb over here is me giving some rooms to special people. And special people are people that come from the UK to talk to you tonight, or people that came in last minute with an awesome talk. So I have some spare rooms, so I sold these rooms to myself for them. And then it was seriously down, and everybody was ordering, like, here, this is 10 orders. Those are the extra meals and stuff. So it was basically coming to a standstill, and we had no more rooms. So I started selling bungalows, and then again it shut up. All the bungalows were gone. And then the sales are, again, dinners from people. So we have two spikes, all the rooms are gone, all the bungalows are gone. So this is how the typical hacker hotel sales curve is like. And I thought it was really nice to share with you. And we have listened to you guys. People wanted to check in early. They say, I want to be early, I want to check in, and I want to be in my rooms. So all the rooms that were available were ready to check in. So you could come in at 13:37 lead time, and you will be able to check in and go straight to your room. People that have a late checkout. So you all, if you have no extra night, you can all stay until 7 o'clock in your rooms. So you can sleep in late, be there, pack your stuff for the people coming from abroad. So we have listened to you. And this is one of the two things that was a lot of feedback on. We have the lunch, the extra lunch. Extra cost, but extra lunch. People missed breakfast and there was like no food. So now there is food. Yeah, thank you. The meals have to be done in two sittings because we're too large. So if you have a Blue Band, not the butter in the Netherlands, but a Blue Band, then you're on the early shift. The early shifts are here. And if you have the Orange Band, you wear the late shift. They are served in the main restaurant. Last year we had food in the bar. We're too large, we cannot eat in the bar, and the bar needs to be available for people that are waiting if you are in the other shift. And you can do games there, you can drink there, you can order tea in the morning. But you have we need the space. So all the meals are served in the restaurant. And this is very important. You must not overstay your sitting. So you have a band, and the times indicated, they must be enforced very strictly. Unfortunately, if you grow, that's a disadvantage. But please listen to the staff if they ask you to leave. And if you're late, just drop stuff on your plate. As an exception, you are allowed to take your plate from the restaurant this year. So you can put all the stuff on it and then leave. But please listen to the staff, especially if they ask you to Foxtrot Oscar. So if they ask you to leave, please listen and fuck off. And then, some people are staying. Some people are helping us. Some people want to drive after, I don't know, church is finished or whatever. So if you want to stay on Sunday, you can have a dinner. It's not in the ticket price, but you're all welcome to stay. It's no problem, you can stay all evening. And that is in the bar area. And there you can order plate service. For the people that are staying on a Sunday, we have breakfast, food and drink. You can buy tokens from 7 till 11, and you can use them all night. The bar will basically stay open as long as we keep drinking. So if you keep on drinking, the bar will stay open. If there's four people sitting at the bar, probably the bartender will ask you to leave. But okay. Also, the next thing, important. You can order at the bar, but they don't serve you at your table. So just, if you order there, bitterball, whatever, bitterballen, they just, you order at the bar, and then it will come to you. Club Mate this year, a very important one, feedback, we listened. One token. Of course, feedback is given during the event, and now the first person came to me. Last year it was like, hey, Coca-Cola is one coin, Club Mate is two coins. Ah, that's expensive, in the space I pay a lot less. So I changed it now, so it's one token for the Mate. And somebody came up to me this afternoon and said, yeah, this Coca-Cola is very expensive, it's one token. So thank you for the feedback, but I cannot drive the price down, and I thought I did a great job on the Mate, so sorry. So everything is now one token. Okay, we have the optional Friday night buffet. Some people use it, like a lot of people, and well, thank you, Mike. I see you liked it. There will be a second limited run of the merchandise, and I have to talk to Tim about the designs, because it was a hell of a job to get all the different designs and all the different types of apparel, and also the mugs were not available. They came from China, and of course with the coronavirus, that was the only thing that was affected. So there were no mugs, so the people that ordered the black mugs, they will be sent to you, but they will be sent to you when they are available. And even for the people in the UK, we will send them to you at no extra cost. And sorry again for not being able to deliver. If you have a problem, speak to us, speak to me, speak to people around me that you think that can bring the message across. Next year, probably Friday will be for full weekenders, because we might grow a little more and then we cannot have the day tickets in. So if you have a day ticket now, I invite you to buy tickets next year for the whole weekend. And else you're very welcome from on Saturday onwards. But Friday will be exclusive, and maybe we have some interesting talks, and we put them all on the Friday, so make sure you're there. Yeah, this was something this was one of the things, if you grow, that was a miscalculation on my side. 20 rooms can be sold as a one-person room, and then there is an additional €50 charge, because if we sell all the rooms in the hotel, 97 of them, we sell them to one person, we can just fill this side of the room. And then there's no room for these people. So I have to pay a surcharge of €50. It was not in your tickets. So this year it came out of, well, funds, sponsors, my funds. So next year there will be 20 rooms on sale for the normal price, or the price that we set for this year, coming year. And then the rest will have a €50 surcharge, so that it doesn't come out of sponsor money, because sponsor money has to go to you and not only to the people in one person rooms. So mind you, when the sale starts, it's 20 rooms cheap. We call that the early bird, and then it will go up steeply. Not because of me, but because I want the sponsor money to be able to afford cool stuff like this stuff. Your feedback is valuable. Very valuable to me, to the event. Last year I received a lot of feedback on the Sunday evening. I was quite frustrated, so if you want to give me feedback, you're all welcome to do so. Positive feedback you can give me during the whole event, I don't mind, but else you can leave it until Tuesday, so I had at least one good night's sleep. And then I'm very happy to accept all your feedback. So thank you for that, please. And there will be probably a form on the website, so you can type it in and I receive it. And I will answer every feedback, so. I'm not sure, I will have to ask my kind friend Ad if he can make me a form, and then it will be there. I will be probably in bed on Monday. So, future challenges. This is one is also important for me and for us as a group, I think. Last week I went to DEF CON Holland, and somebody came up to me and he said, my friends went last year to Hacker Hotel and they weren't that enthusiastic. And I quote, because these are not my words, he said it was a circle jerk of InfoSec people from the Netherlands and it's hard to get into. So I was like, okay. So it turned up that there were four students sitting at the bar all weekend, drinking beer and not mingling with the people. So everybody thought like, okay, they're the group on their own. They didn't approach you, they didn't approach anything. So I think we're open as a community. But feedback is feedback. But in this case, I was like, okay. But there is a deeper point. If we sell out so quickly and you all buy tickets again, then it will be this group. I don't mind, because you are nice people. But it could be viewed that we become like a maybe bigger events that went with work with vouchers, or it's who you know and to get tickets. So I struggle with this question, and if you have feedback on that, please, I'm open for that as well, because I don't know how to keep on doing this. I would love to be here every year with you guys, but yeah, it's a question that could be. And this as well, how to attract every other people that want to come over here, or the sponsors is also a thing, because we have next year we have MCH, and some sponsors already are contemplating sponsoring MCH, which they absolutely should do. So I'd rather be without sponsoring and MCH having to be all the sponsors and being a great event, but it's something that plays in my mind. So, and we need help. This year was the first time I can say it's a we event. Everybody, really seriously, everybody joined in to help. People offered help with the checking in today. I didn't have to check in nobody. Everybody was checked in by other people, which was amazing to see them doing the wristbands and working with the hotel. So thank you for the check-in team. But I also need people during the year, the website. I probably need a content team of respected people from this community, you guys, that can help me judge the talks, ask for more information, ask for a picture, ask for a bio, all the stuff I have to do with 4 or 5 emails. If there's a separate content team, I promise you it will be even better. It's good, but it can be even way better, I think. So I'm looking for a content team. The AV teams, we need people that can film this. So during this event as well, so some people already signed up, we need more cameramen. So if you're thinking of attending a talk, please report to FUBAR. We make a schedule, and if you can do 1 or 2 talks, we have everything on tape. Well, disc, actually, disc. I'm an old guy. Disc. And then we can have it on the channels we have available. So everybody can look back at the talks they missed. We have 3 streams live this event. All the rooms will be streamed live the whole weekend. So if you have friends across the ocean, friends in England or wherever in the world, point them to the link and they can watch live in the event. There's 2 or 3 talks that are not being recorded. That's the AIVD talk, the IVD talk. That's the talk which will follow this talk from Walter, and it's a talk from Misha. So that is the 3 talks that are not being recorded. So, and the NEMTI one also not. That was very important, because if you give people tips how to improve their malware, they might use it against us. So it's not being recorded. So be there, it's a nice talk. So the camera operators. This year we have nice screens. My friend Ad made these screens, info screens. And you can see the schedule on there. There's lots to see. TD Venlo brought the old Spiral game. It's very fun. Bring some drink some drinks and then come and try to do it. It's even harder, so you can easily make it harder. And I invite you all to complete the badge challenge and the coin challenge. One of the important part, the people that make it possible. So here we go. Can I have one continuous round of applause for Guardian 360, Axis 42, Red Team Security, Schuberg Phyllis, KPN ICT Consulting, the silver sponsors, Secura, Sophos, the Sorion, Cybersprint, EZ, and Freedom Internet, really proud. Zerocopter, Bisway, Procolix, OpenBSD, and Jonker. So give it up for them. These guys make this possible. And then the badge sponsors, your badges. Stegen, Jan Los, Aureo ICT, Access 42 again. And Magion, thank you so much. The badge would have been not possible with these badge sponsors. And then of course, you can hear me. Stephen, thank you so much. I have some special mentions next to all these sponsors. Thank you so much. The Angry Nerds, and they are here this weekend. We have live broadcast from Hacker Hotel. Samsung for the nice screens. Really good. The wonderful sponsors and also the speakers. Without them, there would be no content. So thank you so much for all the speakers, for all the workshop leaders. The batch team, and this is very important. The batch team, the batch. It's another masterpiece. It's designed by Nicolette. She made a real design. So last year it was square, it's now a real design. It's a masterpiece, thank you. We have earphones and serial converters, but the serial converters, because of China, we didn't have enough. So if you already have a serial converter, I expect you to be fair and use that to connect this. But if you're new or you want to learn, there's a serial converter available for you at the batch team. So you can hook it up and do that because, I don't know, do it and see what happens. Of course, there were the usual batch issues. Funding was needed till the last minute. Hardware and software issues were discovered, and you can learn all about this. It's coming this weekend. There's a nice talk, but they delivered again. So don't miss this batch talk, team. It's on Sunday, and it will be in this room. And it will start at 2:15, and it's very interesting. So don't miss this. Here we are. Yeah, 2:15 in this room. So please, can I have the batch team forward? Sake. Wait until you unpack this. Renze. Sorry. Sebastius. Benatsky. Noor. Nicolette. Everybody. And Anne-Jan. Anne-Jan already had one. So you can unpack this now because.
Nice and discreetly packaged.
Yeah. This year, maybe you saw this tweet that the batch team said that they made a boo-boo again. So I decided it would be fun to reverse something as well as they did, not revealing too much, but there were some components the other way around. So it says we made a boo-boo again in mirror. So give it up for the awesome batch team. Thank you so much. A very important service announcement about the batch.
Let's see. Oh, this works. Wow. Important service announcement. Please plug in your batteries the right way around because we apparently missed protecting some circuitry and. yeah. More on that later, but there's a little QR code on your back and. Just scan that and see all the documentation. We just pushed a photo of the correct battery orientation to prevent magic smoke. Because if you do get magic smoke, you won't be able to play the game. Yes, don't be on fire. You break the rule, then you get kicked out.
Also, he's not present here because he is in Corona land. We have a very special team member of the batch team, and its name is Norbert. Norbert lives in China and is our supplier of all the parts. So Sebastian and the team have great lots of communication with him. So we bought him a sweater as well in his size. So we're sending stuff back for a change. So thank you all, and give it up for batch team, and don't miss their talk. Yeah, enjoy. Thank you so much. These people work day and night to get you the batch. So Then also, you have received a coin. Some of you may have been cheeky bastards already. Some of you might have not. So I want to have the team forward. So Saki, you could have been here again. This guy worked day and night for the batch team, and then he started working day and night for the coin team for a change. So then Bob is somewhere in the room. So Bob, Ad, and Johan, please come forward. These guys helped me with a coin I engraved for you guys. This coin was engraved during my Christmas holiday. So during the Christmas dinner, every 30 minutes I went down to put 4 coins under the laser. And then I went up back to the family and down and up and down. And that repeated for a week, so I made all the coins myself. But then these guys came up. Oh, thank you for that. And I hope you like it. I did my best, and I learn every day. But these guys came up with ideas to make it even more cool. And they came up with the idea of the challenge coin. So I want to thank these guys because they're good in puzzles and programming, and I'm not, so I need them their help. So I want to take them to an escape room, and I want to play a game with them. So I gave them a voucher. So I will take them on a mission, and hopefully we can get out. And then you'll see us again next year. So thank you, guys. Thank you so much. So play the game. Thank you, guys. As I said, working very late. This man over there, the other guys, programming deep into the night. Last night, even. Look. I said, okay, 2:20, I said, I'm really go to sleep now. I went up at 7 in the morning to bring all the stuff in here. And then at 2:30, I was like, okay, I'm dying, I go to bed now. And then this man, Saka, look at the time. This guy is up until 4:30, working on your coins. So, thank you, Saga, again. It's amazing work. Thanks, Bob, for programming all night. Thanks, Johan, for help with all the puzzles, and Ad for the website part. Oops, spoiler. Okay. The logo design. There's two ladies that submitted designs, and one gentleman, Ad. Ad made the stickers that are there with the hearts. So that was Ad's design. So we decided to print stickers of that. And then the two ladies that sent in logo designs are Janneke and Chantal. And I want to have them forward, please. So Janneke and Chantal, if you're here. Thank you so much for designing. Where is Janneke? Okay. But then please come forward and you can accept her prize. So, hey! So they won their own design on a hoodie. And for the people that don't know, this was Chantal's design. Okay. There's no confetti in it, I promise you. But it's really cool. So I hope it went the right way around. So Chantal, yeah. This is Chantal's design, the heart and the mind, the heart and the mind coming together. Okay. This is Chantal's design. So thank you so much for submitting designs. You are way better in this than me. So again, a nice example how outsourcing really works. So thank you so much and give it up for the two awesome batch designs. Chantal and Janneke. And if you look carefully, you see the old batch of last year and you see a part of the new batch. Without the network, a hacker event would be nothing. We need streams, we need internet, we need to look up stuff. So thanks Event Infra for all the bits on the network, the switches, the routers, the cables, the access points. So give it up for Event Infra. The hotel and the staff were really lovely to work with. I think I called the hotel 10 times a day, and even at the 10th time, Evelyn picked up the phone, and she said, hello, what can I do for you now? And it was all in good fun, and we had lots of fun working together, and every change almost every change. If it wasn't administered, it was my fault. Then I forgot to tell her, but everything I sent at her, she put in the lists, all the your rooms, all the swaps, all the last minute people that came to the event. So that's really great. And last night, they have a new barman, basically a bar team, Kyriakos and Stuart, and these guys are really magic. You will all see tonight. We had a big party last night. You saw it, 2:20, I went to bed. So these guys really make the event and the hotel really worthwhile. So thanks for them, for all their good care for us. And of course, if you respect your environment, you can come back next year. And then the volunteers, Niels for helping with the website, Mark for doing the video, Roy for helping with the network, Dennis for setting up the AV, the Brexiteers, Mike for helping me with this awesome presentation, Ian for helping me run the cables, Jenny for lifting the high stuff. Thank you so much. And all your positive publications are really much appreciated. Daan and Erik helping out and also organizing a welding workshop. Jitske for testing all the stuff, helping out, adding stuff on the coins maybe. I'm not sure. Michel, Pim, Dimitri, thank you for helping out with the videoing. And everyone I forget now, because you always forget someone if you do it like this. But I really wanted to have a big round of applause for all these people. And then here you see him. I wanted to give him a special recommendation. If people say they're helping, they're really helping if they are like Mendel. Thank you so much. Mendel drove up to the hackerspace and he said, "You're not answering your phone, but I know you're on the hackerspace on Wednesday evenings. So I need to know these dimensions, these colors. How big do you want this? Where do you want this flag?" And then he went to the hotel, I took all the measurements, and he just did it, and it's all there, and I didn't have to do anything. So thank you, Mendel, for helping me out like a true friend. Much appreciated. And of course, Anneliese, for sticking up with me, talking about Hacker Hotel for a full year. So thank you so much. Now we come to an important part, and Jos specifically asked me to talk to you guys, because I think it's important, but there's no one that can do it better than you. So if you can come forward.
Hello. Hello. About a year and a half ago, we lost a dear friend, Arjen Kamphuis. You probably heard about that. To commemorate his work, we tried to find everything he ever wrote and put it in one book, which will be on sale here. And you can also order it online. And I don't know where the booth is, but you'll find it during the weekend. And also to do the same, we also have a exposition of pictures and paintings that will happen, that has been happening for the last weeks already, and this weekend it also will be open. Actually, it will open especially for you guys. Wow. There will be, I'll have the time frame here, tomorrow at noon, and you will be back again in time if you have the late lunch. So if you have the late lunch, you can go see pictures at noon, and that's at noon. At the entrance, just stick around there. There will be people will do some carpooling and get back there, back here at 1:30-ish. At Sunday, 12:45, we'll do the same for the early birds. So if you're an early eater, then you can do that one. And you can buy the book at shop.hack42.nl. And if you just want to pick it up here, then say that you, just click pick up, and then it will happen. Yes?
There are four openings for every lunch on every day.
Apparently, there's a lunch for all the openings. Blah. All the lunches will have an opening. Yeah. we'll put that on online somewhere. Okay.
Thank you, Jos.
And I want to give you one of the books.
That's much appreciated.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Awesome book. get it. Finally. I'm waiting for the confirmation, but we can be back here if we want to next year. And I can spoil it will be on Valentine's weekend again. Not that I like Valentine's so much, but maybe other events in Europe wanted to adjust their dates with me. I can only leave it at that. But Valentine's weekend next year, if we get the confirmation, then we will be back. I want to wish you all the fun. Watch all the talks, go to workshop, go to the area, go to badge team. One thing is very important, if you get stuck with your badge and you don't and not able to solve it, there is a Twitter account of some person very dearly who's here in Hacker Hotel. It's a Twitter account, and I do it by heart, but I think it's at HH2020badge. If you send him a message and you say, I'm stuck, I don't know how to solve this, maybe you get some hints to get you further. So at HH2020badge, Twitter account, before I forget. And then the last thing, and I talked about this before, and I'll keep it short because Walter is waiting to give you a very awesome talk. Don't forget, stay safe. We even have Hacker Hotel condoms. And remember, be excellent to each other. Don't be an asshole. Don't do anything that you wouldn't like to be done to you. Please keep this a safe environment where people can leave their laptops and go to a talk, can leave stuff around without being stolen. Let's try to prove that we as a community can do this, and your stuff is safer, and you as a person, more important, you as a person are safer. And then we don't need no long rule book. Just don't put stickers on the hotel. So have fun. Thank you so much. Oh, sorry. I forgot something very important. I'm also the lost and found department. So somebody lost this purple thingy with coins, and because we have a coin pusher and we requested everybody to bring old coins, and these are all just 1 and 2 cents. So if you lost a purple monkey near the entrance, then you can collect it with me. It's a purple monkey. It's got some 1 and 2 cent coins for the coin pusher, I hope. So if somebody lost this, you can pick it up with me. And now, thank you so much.